We're in Mishnah, Nazir, Perek Aleph, Mishnah, Dalet, fourth Mishnah, the first chapter of Mishnah, Nazir. We learned previously that there were three types of nezirut in Mishnah Bet. We learned there was called Stam Nezirut, which is, which all three acts are prohibited: wine, drinking wine, getting a haircut, getting tameh. And we learned Nezirut Shimshon, where the Nazir Shimshon can become tameh. We also learned this thing called Nezir Olam, Nezirut Olam. Nezirut Olam means a person takes an eternal nezirut, but we all, the halacha of eternal nezirut is if his hair got heavy, then he's allowed to take a haircut. If his hair got heavy, the halacha is that's echat l'shnei masar chodesh. That's once every 12 months, i.e., once a year. And he can take a haircut if it becomes heavy once a year. That's not more than that, even if his hair grows very, very fast. Okay, our Mishnah is going to talk about different types of nezirut. As we're talking about how long does a nezirut, we said a person can take on more than one nezirut in a row. He can take on two in a row. He can take on three in a row. The stam nezirut of shloshim yom, says the Mishnah. Hareini nazir kisa'ar roshi. Why a person would say this, I have no idea, but he did. I am a nazir like the hairs on my head. So obviously I wouldn't have that many nezirut. Actually, you would, because even a bald person has a lot of hair. Ukafar ha'aretz. Or, I'm a nazir like the dust of the ground. Ukachol ayom. Okay, like the sand of the seas. Harei ze nazir olam. The Mishnah says, he is a nazir olam. But, umagaleach achat l'shloshim yom. But he takes a haircut once every 30 days. Whoa, let's look back at our chart. We just said nazir olam is only once every 12 months. So how could he be nazir olam and take a haircut once every 30 days? The Bar Tanura says, La nazir olam mamash, not really a nazir olam. Like we said, the ilan nazir olam megalech echad l'shnei masar chodesh. A real nazir olam takes a haircut once a year. V'zeh megalech echad l'shloshim. I mean, this guy's doing it every 30 days. Okay? Ho il, so the Bar Tudor explains, since v'tala naziruto b'dvarim chalukim, he connected, or he conditioned his nazirut, the way he described it was dvarim chalukim, hairs of his head. Those are a lot. Havik ilu nadar b'minyan nezirutav k'minyan se'ar rosho ve'afar ha'aretz. It's as if he said the following: I accept on myself the amount of neziriyot like the hairs on my head. So therefore, it's not a nezirut, not a nezir olam, but rather it's a gazillion subsequent neziriyot. Masha'en came, which is not true, but nezir olam. Nezir olam, an eternal nazir, shelo chalak nezirut shelo. He didn't divide it, he made one nezirut. So therefore, according to the Tanakhama, this person is nezir olam, but not really nezir olam, because he could take a haircut, i.e. he took on an unlimited number of consecutive neziruyot. So every 30 days, he can break it and start again. Rabbi says, Ein ze megaleach echad l'shloshim yom. Rabbi says, no, that's, if he says, Hareini nazir kisear roshi, that guy is a nazir olam. He's a real nazir olam. It's one nezirut. He said nazir. It's one. Ezeh u'shemegaleach echad l'shloshim yom. What is the language which would have a person be able to take a haircut every 30 days, i.e. subsequent regular neziruyot? Ha'omer harei alai nezirut kisear roshi. I take upon myself nezirut like the hairs of my head. Ke'afar ha'aretz. Like the dirt of their land, like the sand. Meaning, once he says, because if he says nezirut, more than one, because then if he uses that language, it's as if he is dividing up separate nezirut. We'll stop here and dedicate our learning, as we always do, to the memory of my father, Rav Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. Have a good day.